Ladies and gentlemen, everybody is talking about high debt as a consequence of Corona. I analyze who is really in debt and what that could mean for the future. Let's get one thing clear at the outset. Private households don't get into debt. In most countries, they receive a lot of state money in the form of short-time work or unemployment benefits or other subsidies. As a result, US citizens' income have even risen recently and their debt have fallen. On the other hand, companies have been forced to incur more debt to compensate for the revenue loss caused by Corona. This will force companies, especially in the US and China, to save on investment and hiring in order to repay the debt. Much more new debt than companies have been taken on by the states. In the US, the sovereign debt to GDP ratio will soon be as high as at the end of the Second World War. Many countries in the Eurozone, especially Italy, has also so far heavily indebted. With their high debt levels, the states have been able to absorb Corona-related income losses by private households and companies. This stabilizes the economic situation in the here and now, but everything has its price. Highly indebted states will put great pressure on their central banks not to raise their interest rates even after the epidemic has ended. This will make future asset price bubbles much more likely. Thank you very much for your attention.